To ward off the threat of war in Europe, Chamberlain traveled to Obersalzberg to meet with Hitler in September of 1938. In accordance with his policy of appeasement, that is, making concessions with the aim of finding a peaceful solution for Europe, Chamberlain agreed to Hitler's demand for the Sudetenland to be ceded to the German Reich. Together with the Italian dictator Mussolini and the French Prime Minister Edouard Daladier, he and Hitler signed the so-called Munich Agreement, which stipulated the cession of the Sudetenland. In return, England and France guaranteed the continued existence of the remaining Czechoslovakian state. Czechoslovakia was not treated as a subject of international law in the agreement, but as an object, and had to comply with the agreement. After the signing, Chamberlain returned to Great Britain and announced that he had secured lasting peace for Europe. Peace in our time, as he put it. However, the agreement soon proved to be illusory. After the invasion of Prague by German troops, Chamberlain announced the end of his appeasement policy in a speech in Birmingham and concluded guarantee agreements with Poland, Greece, Romania, and Turkey in the event of a German attack. In September of 1939, Chamberlain's government declared war on Germany following the invasion of Poland. Due to his indecisive conduct of the war and the failed British expedition to Norway, Chamberlain lost the confidence of the Conservatives within a few months of the start of the war and was replaced as Prime Minister by Winston Churchill. He died shortly afterwards on November 9, 1940, in Heckfield, near Reading. Chamberlain's political legacy remains controversial. While on the one hand he was criticized as a naive and weak leader who underestimated Hitler and led Britain into war unprepared, supporters argued that his appeasement policy bought the country time to strengthen and rearm its armed forces. Domestically, his political legacy is undisputed, as Chamberlain changed the lives of many Britons for the better. Well, so much for Neville Chamberlain, and until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.